Hello everyone and welcome back to another book review. Today I'm going to be reviewing volume 41 in the series I have been reading, Haikyuu by Haruichi Furudate. This is what the cover of this volume looks like. In this volume, I'm going to assume that you have some familiarity with the series thus far, so I'm just going to jump in and start talking about what's going on in this volume and how I thought about volume 41. So this volume is actually a continuation of a game that started in a previous volume, and this is Karasuno High School, which is the team we are following, versus the team Kamomadai, I believe is how you would say it, during the Tokyo Spring Volleyball Tournament. So this is a huge tournament, and this day that these teams are playing in is a huge day. They've had two games today, so they are quite exhausted, and both games have gone on to three sets. So volleyball is played best two of three, so if someone wins the first two, there's no need to play that third set. But in both games, they're going to have to go to the third set. So the first game, Karasuno won, so they've advanced to this game. And Kamomadai, of course, has also won their previous game, and they are playing in this second game of the day, and the first two sets were split between the teams, so they're having to play in a third set. Both teams are incredibly exhausted, and they're trying their best to win this so they can continue to advance in the tournament. I promise someday I will finish reading the series and watch the anime, and then I can actually learn how to pronounce all of these names and find out that I've been pronouncing them horribly incorrect. So I apologize if any of these names are not correct. Kamomadai has a player who kind of acts as a, I don't want to say foil, but a comparison to Hinata. Hinata's on the Karasuno team. He's short, but he has aims to become a great volleyball player. Volleyball is a sport in which height is quite important. Kamomadai has a player called Korai Hoshiyumi, who also aims to be a very good volleyball player despite being on the shorter end of height. So both of these teams have a player who have something to prove, and they both want to give it their all and be the best shorter player on the court. So they're kind of fighting against each other in this game. So this entire volume, volume 41, is just focused on set three. We do not get beyond set three in this. Set three is where we start, and the game has not concluded, or sorry, the set has not concluded, although this set will conclude the game by the end of the volume. So this is a very focused volume, and I would recommend having volume 42 queued up, ready to go, so you don't get left hanging if you do read this volume. We do have this back and forth going on between Hinata and Hoshiyumi. We see the exhaustion, and this is a very furious game back and forth. The tournament is set up so that if you lose, you don't go to like a loser's bracket or something, you just immediately leave the tournament. So you do have this very furious fighting between the teams to advance on, and both teams are quite good. I do feel like Kamomadai kind of has a little bit of the momentum right now. They just seem to be a little bit stronger, while Karasuno is kind of almost on their back foot, and you do see that especially closer to the end of the volume, which I will talk about in the second. Something I'm learning with this series is as the art advances, if you have not seen the volleyball hit the floor and you're on one page, I have an example. So we have this panel at the bottom here where it looks like the volleyball is probably going to hit the floor, but we haven't seen it hit the floor in this panel. And we flip the page, and that is Hoshiyumi right there, at least I believe that is, getting the ball. So I have learned in this series that if you have not seen the volleyball hit the ground, the volleyball has not hit the ground. So don't count anything until you've actually seen it in the art. Don't make assumptions or try to think panels ahead. The fighting in this game, or the competition between the two teams, is very intense. I do think Kamomadai kind of has a little bit more momentum. They seem to just have the slight edge, but Karasuno has played teams that have had, in my opinion, a little bit of an edge above them. But things get very dicey at the end. If you don't want any spoilers, click off now. At the end, Hinata, who has been pushing very, very hard, he has always full of energy, he always has been someone who gives his all on the volleyball court, winds up collapsing, and he has a fever. He has pushed himself way too hard, and his coach tells him, in good faith, I cannot let you go back out there until you have recovered. So you're going to have to take care of your body. And knowing when to push and knowing when to rest is kind of these two opposites. And I mean, anything, exercise, work, whatever you're doing, knowing when you need to push yourself and knowing when you need to rest. And Hinata hasn't quite found that balance yet. And unfortunately, at the end of this set, he finds out that he is not going to be able to re-enter the volleyball game, which he's quite exhausted and he's pushed himself too far and he needs to recover. So the coach just tells him to think about this and make sure that he takes care of his body in the future, but he can't let him continue to play volleyball. So now Karasuno High School is going to have to continue the rest of set three without one of their star players, Hinata, and that is where the volume kind of ends, leaving a lot of questions, and I think most readers will want to jump directly into volume 42 for that reason. The cover has our two players facing each other. I feel like the cover is quite good. I really enjoyed this series. I feel like the author, Furudate, hasn't really played with the idea of Hinata being pulled out of a game, like, permanently, and he kind of is at this point. He's not going to be able to play any further, and there's questions on how long it's going to take for him to recover. So I think that this is a really interesting twist, and I like the fact that the author really doesn't have anything that's safe. I like the fact that the author doesn't keep anything too sacred, in the sense that a player can never get hurt or everything always has to go well. So I do like that aspect, and I think we're seeing that with the fact that Hinata winds up being pulled out of the game and not being able to continue playing at the end of volume 41. If you've read volume 41 and have thoughts on it, please leave it down below. I love to receive it. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great rest.